Luke Thomas in St. Louis, Missouri, just hours before Bellator 138, next to one of the announced participants in the September 19th one-night four-man Bellator light heavyweight tournament, King Mo Lawal. Lawal, Mr. Lawal, I should say, nice to see you. I'm sorry about your terrible taste in rap music. I'll forgive it this time. I'm teasing a little bit. We're talking off the air. But this event, this is so out of left field, but you fought in Japan. You sort of seen the aesthetic there. Are you glad this kind of thing is being brought to the States? It's like MMA sort of felt like the innovation's kind of gone. This feels like you're bringing it back a little bit. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I feel like you get to realize, like, people want to make it seem like MMA is a sport. It is, but it's more entertainment. This right here brings the sport aspect in it because it's a tournament, but brings the entertainment aspect in it too, as well, you know? So people have to realize, like, you have to get a little of both. And I think this right here, the show, the tournament, the kickboxing along with the MMA is great entertainment. Everybody wants to see an ass whooping, so you have a chance to get an ass whooping in the square circle and the cage.
Any chance of the crowd responding more favorably to one than the other?
Nah, I don't think so. I think a knockout's a knockout. So if you get stretched in the square circle or you get stretched in the cage, you're going to hear a cheer regardless.
So I asked Emmanuel Newton this question. You fought him twice. Would you like the opportunity to face him in this tournament, or could be Phil, could be Linton, doesn't really matter?
To me, it don't matter, but I'd love to fight him first round, finals, whatever, you know what I'm saying? I'd love to because I got to put these hands on him, you know what I'm saying? I thought I did a good job with the last fight, but they didn't give me the decision. But like, I came out unscathed, I busted him up, I did damage, but I guess they liked the volume of what he was throwing, I guess. I don't know. But we'll have a chance to you know, redo all this because now I'm feeling good, I'm on point, I'm healthy, I can run, I can do all this stuff. When I first came to Bellator, man, I couldn't do none of that. I was a one-legged fighter. You know what I'm saying? I was more flat-footed. Now I can move, I can throw, I can do what I need to do, you know what I'm saying, and look good.
So I'm just curious about where you're headed because you fought Chet Congo at heavyweight. You won, out-wrestled him, and now you're doing a one-night four-man tournament, but it feels like the winner of that might get a title shot. And I'm sort of wondering, are you just interested in the big money fights and the spectacle, or does the title looming over this tournament sort of hang in your mind as well?
My overall goal is to win this tournament, which I will, win the belt, which I will, then challenge the heavyweight champion for their belt, which I will. And if I have to go to 185, whatever, eventually, you know what I'm saying? But I want to get the heavyweight title. I wish Minakawa was around so I could fight him, but he probably seems like he's not going to be around. So whoever has the belt at heavyweight, I'm going to try to unify the 205 title with the heavyweight title and have two belts when I go to the ring.
Has Coker weighed in on this at all?
No, because after I win this 205 title and defend it, I'm going to demand it, you know what I'm saying? I got a bald head, you know what I'm saying? I got a bald head.
I don't get the reference. What does that mean?
Look at Big Brody on Instagram, Big Brody.
I'll look that up. Mo Lawal, we got to listen to more Sean Price. I appreciate your time. Best of luck to you on September 19th. I guess we'll hear and talk to you soon.
All right, cool. Yeah, yes. What's up?
Thanks.